integrated pest management in sugarcane. About 220 insect pests and 76 non-insect pests ravage the sugarcane crop in India. Depending upon the severity of infestation, this can drastically bring down the yield and recovery in sugar factories and also affect the quality of jaggery produced. The long duration of the crop, extending from 10 to 14 months, followed by one or two ratoons, staggered planting and extensive cultivation of a few varieties over large areas, make it ideal for high buildup of some pests. In integrated pest management, pests are contained below economic injury level by the adoption of available technologies. It involves a balance between biological, chemical, and cultural measures and is done through consideration of the economic protection from pest damage and the ecological and social implications of its use. Among the borers infesting sugarcane crop, the early shoot borer or Chilo infuscatilus is widely distributed in all the sugarcane growing areas of the country. The pest usually attacks during the early part of cane growth, before internode formation. The borer larvae enter the shoot laterally, below the ground level, by one or more holes in the stalks and kill the growing plant. Thus, they cut off the central leaf spindle, which eventually dries, forming a dead heart. The dead heart can be easily pulled out. It emits an offensive odor, typical to shoot borer infestation. In summer, when irrigation is under constraint, infested shoot dry and compensating tillers are not formed, leading to gaps in the field. The intensity of attack by the shoot borer increases in summer months if the crop is less than 90 days old. Hence, in endemic locations, plant the crop before December to desynchronize the optimum crop stage with the optimum summer months. Light earthing upon the 30th day. Frequent irrigation and trash mulching also reduces infestation. Chlorpyrifos 20 EC may be applied when the dead heart count reaches 25 per 100 shoots. Mix 50 ml of the insecticide in 10 liters of water and apply to the leaf whorls of the shoots by high-volume knapsack or backpack sprayers. Do not use low-volume sprayers or power sprayers. The 10-liter spray solution is applied to a 100-meter row length in a 90-centimeter spaced planting. At this rate of application, 2 liters of insecticide and 400 liters of water are required. The internode borer, Chilo saccharifagus indicus, is a major pest of sugarcane in peninsular India. It damages the crop soon after internode formation and its activity continues until harvest. It shows reduced activity in flowered cane, while lodged canes and crops in waterlogged areas are severely ravaged by this pest. When the borer attacks the apical bud, the crop growth is abruptly arrested, leading to reduction in yield. It induces sprouting of axial buds and forms dead hearts and bunchy tops as produced by the top borer. Hence, the quality deteriorates. When jaggery is prepared from canes attacked by internode borer, setting becomes difficult or the color turns out dark. The pest infestation can be minimized by detrashing during 5th and 7th month. The borer pupates outside the cane in the leaf sheath. Detrashing removes the pupae and denies the site for pupation. Alternately, use pheromone traps from the 5th to 11th month. 10 SBI traps are required per acre, and the lures need to be changed twice in a 45-day interval, that is, at the 6.5 month and 8th month. The SBI trap is set at 75 to 90 centimeters on the 5th month crop and at 150 centimeters at 6.5 months onwards. Release Trichogramma clonis 6 times at fortnightly intervals from 4th month onwards at the rate of 2 cc per acre per release. Top borer or Scirpophaga excerptalis is a major pest of sugarcane in subtropical India. It infests sugarcane during all the stages of crop growth. Tunneling within the midrib, short holes on lamina and dead hearts are characteristic symptoms of top borer attack. In grown-up canes, the infestation results in sprouting of the buds, producing a bunchy top appearance. Under subtropical conditions, mechanical collection of egg masses commencing with brood emergence at 4-day intervals, selective destruction of non-parasitized eggs and roguing of affected sugarcane tops before moth emergence on a campaign basis are quite effective. SBI trap pheromone traps set the rate of 10 per acre are set 2 to 3 days prior to brood emergence. Trap height is 45 cm for the young crop and 150 cm for the grown-up crop. Chilo aureciliaceus, commonly referred to as the stock borer, is a major pest in Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. Its larvae attack shoots as well as grown-up cane and are capable of attacking any region of cane stalk. In infested canes, the damaged internodes show symptoms of reddening and sometimes emit a rancid odor. It is the only borer that does not hibernate during winter and is very active during this period. To manage this pest, release Trichogramma clonis at 2 cc per acre at 10 locations every fortnight from the 5th to 11th month of crop. At the same time, deploy pheromone traps, namely the SBI trap, at 10 per acre, maintained at a height of 90 centimeters. The lures should be changed every 45 days. Gurdaspur borer or Acigona stenilus is yet another serious pest of the subtropics. Its large-scale occurrence in Gurdaspur district of Punjab gives it its name. The larvae feed gregariously in a spiral manner upon entry into the top tender internode, making minute punctures on the rind from within. Externally, the tunnel appears as a dark spiral made up of a series of punctures lying side by side like beads in a rosary. As a control measure, periodically collect and destroy the canes showing primary infestation. Root borer or Emalocera depressella that infests the underground portion of canes. It never feeds on the roots. Hence, the term root borer is a misnomer. It infests young shoots and causes dead hearts. In the grown-up crop, no external symptom is seen except yellowing of lower leaves. The dead heart cannot be pulled out easily like the dead heart caused by the early shoot borer. When pulled, the plant usually gets uprooted and the larva can be seen. Applying chlorpyrifos in the soil around the collar region of plants at the time of brood emergence will kill the neonate larvae before it enters the cane stalk. Light hoeing around the clumps and earthing up block the exit hole of moths in the soil. The sucking pests infesting sugarcane include pyrilla, scale insect, mealy bug, white fly and white woolly aphid. Pyrilla is one of the most destructive foliate sucking pests of sugarcane. The adult and the nymph suck leaf sap from the undersurface of the leaves, resulting in yellowish white spots. Their honeydew secretions encourage sooty mold growth, which hinders photosynthesis and gives a sickly appearance to the field. Pyrilla has 5 nymphal instars. The skin molted at each stage sticks to the leaves persistently, giving the illusion of heavy infestation. Redistribution and mass release of Epirikania melanoleuca provides effective suppression of pyrola. For this, collect egg masses of Epirikania and release them in the field by stapling them on the undersurface of the leaves infested with pyrola. Scale insect or Melanaspis glomerata is a sucking pest of the sugarcane stalk. Scales usually establish on the stem covered with leaf sheath. When the infestation is heavy, the entire stem is covered by the scale insect and its encrustation gives it a grayish-black appearance. As old scale insects remain stuck to the cane stalk even after death, it gives the illusion of severe infestation of the entire stalk. Avoid ratooning fields infested by scale insect. While there are three species of white flies infesting sugarcane, Allurolobus barodensis bears economic relevance. The nymphs of white flies suck the sap from under the surface of the leaves, which turn yellow and pinkish. The sooty mold caused by the fungus Capnodium species covers heavily infested leaves, adversely affecting photosynthesis. Augment Amytus minervae from places of abundance. 10 to 20 leaves bearing Amytus minervae parasitized white fly puparia are loosely bundled in a cloth and tied at 10 or 20 places in the field for Amytus to emerge out, and white fly adults are trapped in the cloth. Spray 0.1% monocrotophos, directing the spray fluid to cover the undersurface of the leaves. Repeat spraying after 15 days. Avoid blanket spraying of the entire field. The white grub, Holotrichia species, damages roots and underground stalks of cane in patches in the field. In endemic conditions, the entire crop dries. To control it, collect adult beetles from host trees on the night of the first summer shower and continue for up to 5 subsequent nights. In grub endemic areas, deeply plow the fields near neem trees during the months from September to February to expose the grubs, pupae and quiescent adults to sun drying, avian and other predation whenever possible. Retaining or stagnating rainwater in fallow fields for 48 hours also brings larvae to surface, which can be then collected and destroyed. In standing crop, depending on availability of water and type of soil, water can be stagnated for 48 hours to kill the grubs. Crop rotation with paddy may also be taken up to eliminate the underground population of grub stages. Entomopathogenic nematodes are also available to combat this pest effectively. 13 species of termites have been reported to infest sugarcane. The termites attack sets, shoots, canes, and also the stubbles soon after planting till harvest. They gain entry through the cut ends or through buds of the sets and feed on the soft tissue, replacing them with soil. Eventually, the infested canes dry up. Damage is relatively high under conditions of drought and in light textured soils. As a control measure, destroy mounds in and around sugarcane fields. Use an insecticide solution of 50 ml chlorpyrifos 20 EC in 10 liters of water to saturate the underground galleries of the mound to kill the queen. If the queen is not killed, fresh soil deposits will appear above ground after 10 to 15 days. In that case, make deep holes in and around the mound with a crowbar and apply the insecticide solution to kill the queen. In the standing crop, apply chlorpyrifos 20 EC in and around the infested clumps. Dip the sets, particularly the cut ends, in Confidor solution, 4 ml in 10 liters of water, and plant them to get protection against termite for 25 to 30 days.